laughs. I don't know if they're even, but if they're not, don't call me out on it. But yeah, I just lift them off camera because if I did those with y'all, this video will be like 3 hours long, and I'm not even lying. So I already did them off camera, and now I'm gonna go ahead and conceal my eyes with this Too Faced Born This Way concealer. I have it in the shade Porcelain. I don't know if I can see that right there. This is porcelain. Just a little something like that to give it some color. Now I'm gonna use my Airspun setting powder and translucent extra coverage. And I'm gonna go ahead and set my eyes. So typically whenever I'm doing eyeshadow, I do my eyes first and then I move on to the face. But since I'm not doing eyeshadow and I'm only doing lashes, I'm just gonna go ahead and do my whole face first and then go back to the eyes. But yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and prep my face. So what I do first, I started doing this recently and I did notice a difference. So I prep my face with this Pure Rose Hip Seed Oil. Oh, excuse my cursing now. Sorry, I haven't got them done. But so this is what I start with. I don't know if you guys can see it. It's just Pure Rose Hip Oil. I heard a lot of good things about this, that it's good for like anti-aging and stuff and for moisturizing. And lately my skin's been hella dry, but yeah, so I've been prepping my face with that. A little bit goes a long way, so I just get like a few drops like that and put it all over my face. But I try to concentrate it like in the areas that get really, really dry and crusty. So I'd say probably like my chin and the edges of my nose and down here. And then like right here by my piercing, it gets hella dry. I don't know why, but it does. So I'm just gonna go ahead and get that shit right there. And then on my forehead, cause my forehead be crusty too. Just dab that in. I've been using this It Secret Sauce. It's an anti-aging moisturizer. This is the little travel size one. It's so cute and little. Yeah, it just looks like that. Clear top. And yeah, it just looks like that. And so with this, also a little bit goes a long way. It's really moisturizing. I've been using it for the past couple of days and it looks pretty good on the skin after I apply my foundation. So I'll just go ahead and put that in all the areas that I put the oil. And you can tell like it's really moisturizing. Y'all hear that? That shit's sticky. So after I finish applying my moisturizer, I go ahead and go with my primer. And lately, I've been really liking this e.l.f. face primer. It's a poreless primer. Y'all, oh my god, I really honestly can't believe I'm filming this video. If y'all know me, I wear makeup literally every day, everywhere, because I'm freaking insecure of my bare face. So, I hope y'all are proud of me for posting this, because it took a lot out of me. I'm crying inside. Okay. But yeah, I've always been really insecure of my bare face. So I let my primer sink in for a little bit, and now I'm gonna go in with my favorite foundation that I've been using so far for the past like few weeks, I think. It's the Wet n Wild Stick Foundation. I have the shade Soft Beige. And bro, oh my god, I'm almost gone. It lasted me a long time though. I'm over here saying a couple weeks. I've used this for a couple months and I love it. At first I didn't like it, but I realized it's how you prep your skin. So since I've been doing like these steps, like this shit looks so bomb. So what I do first, I just go ahead and do a couple streaks on each side. And I like full coverage, like no matter where I'm going, I like my foundation to be full coverage. So I just go ahead and put it like that. And after that, I'm gonna go ahead and grab my beauty blender and then I'm gonna spray it with some of my Mario Badescu rose water because I'm too lazy to get up and wet my beauty blender. And yeah, then I'm just gonna go ahead and start blending everything in. Oh, this is so hard. I'm gonna keep spraying it. And honestly, like, it's not full coverage at first. You have to keep applying layers. But the good thing about it is that no matter how many layers you apply, it doesn't look cakey. So that's what I really like about it. I'm gonna switch to my other beauty blender because shit hard. I just go ahead and go in with my Too Faced concealer that I used in the beginning to prime my eyelids. And I'm just gonna go ahead and highlight my eyes. Boom. This concealer is no joke. It's so full coverage. Whatever my foundation didn't cover up, this shit will cover it up. This will cover it. So I just highlight it under my eyes and then right here because I get redness, and then up here because people do it and I was like, okay, why not? And then down here because I have dark spots from my old pimples and I just want to cover those up. Look at that highlighted eye. Oh my god. What y'all think? Is that good enough? I'm gonna go ahead and put some more. I'm gonna just put some more, just a little bit. I don't know, I just like looking really bright. I don't know, it makes me feel more youthful. I'm acting like I'm like 50 years old. I don't know, I just feel like it looks really nice whenever your under eyes are bright. Okay. Oh wait, I think I missed a spot. I don't know why I look so light in the camera. It doesn't even look that light. Okay, whatever. I'm just gonna go ahead with my air spun that I used to set my eye in the beginning. And I'm gonna use that to set under my eyes and the rest of my face. Now I'm gonna show you guys the lashes that I use. So I get a lot of questions about my lashes, and they're from this brand right here. It's Slay Baby Lashes on Instagram. It's literally just Slay Baby Lashes. Y'all can look it up, or you can literally just click on any of my pictures and click on their Instagram. They have a lot of new styles that come in all the time, and they always have deals, always. So I mean, you get really pretty nice quality lashes for like $12 or less sometimes. So yeah, gotta check them out. Bro, I keep dropping stuff. And today I'm gonna be wearing this style. Oh my god, I'm so scared they're gonna fall off. I already wore these ones, so that's why they're not sticking, but they're these. The style is called High Key. Oh my god. Oh yeah, there's one. And there goes none. I'm gonna go ahead and put those on and I'll be right back. Now that the lashes are applied, I'm gonna go ahead and move back onto the face. So I'm gonna go ahead and start bronzing. So what I've been using is the Wet n Wild contouring palette. It's this, but I'm freaking dropped. See, I'm so clumsy. So I have the caramel toffee, and I'm gonna go ahead and start bronzing my face with that. And I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my Wet n Wild blush and keep it peachy. It's a really pretty peachy shade, obviously, but it looks really pretty on the cheeks. It's really natural. It looks like you're blushing for real. I'm just gonna go back to my eyes and apply some mascara on my lower lash line so it doesn't look too naked. I'm using my Telescopic Carbon Black, by the way. After I finish doing my bottom lashes, I'm going back to my face. And I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my Fenty highlighter. Bro, this is what I'm working with. This is what I'm working with. Rode here on the bus. Now you're one of us. It was magic hour. So I think that's it for my face. Now I'm gonna go ahead and grab my Morphe setting spray. This is my favorite setting spray. If y'all haven't used this, y'all need to get it. It literally sprays like magic. I don't know. I like that it's a mist and it doesn't like spritz your face so hard. It literally just glides on. Watch. I spray a shit ton of this. And my makeup still don't be staying sometimes. But it's good. It's just my face. Y'all saw that? Perfect. It literally makes everything blend in so seamlessly. Like, you don't see all the powders from the highlighter or anything. Just looks so good. So last but not least, I'm gonna go in with my favorite nude. This is a nude that I've been loving so far. I found it at the drugstore. It's a Milani Amore Satin Matte Lip Cream. It's in the shade 01 Lavish. It's this pretty light, it's like a rosy nude. It's really pretty. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this on and I'll be right back. If I saw you on the street, would I have you in my dreams tonight? How pretty is this nude? I feel like it goes with any look. So this is the finished look. This is my everyday makeup look that I wear almost everywhere. I wear it to work, I wear it to go shopping, to run errands. It's just something that I throw on. It's really easy, quick, and yeah. So I wear lashes like this every day, sometimes more dramatic. I don't know, I just really like dramatic lashes. I feel like it adds a lot to the look. You could just do a simple face look and add some lashes and girl, you poppin'. But yeah, so this is the look and I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know it was kinda all over the place, but I'm still getting back into the groove. of doing YouTube videos, but if you guys want to see more or have any suggestions, just be sure to like and subscribe and comment down below and let me know what you want to see next. And yeah, thanks for watching. Bye.